Thanks for the invitation to come and contribute to this event. Here's the challenge of being the last speaker. Good news is I'm not the one standing in between you and your team. There is another panel, so bear with me. Here we are to emphasize how Azerbaijan today stands as a haven for religious tolerance. This is what we actually expect from all modern countries. And when I say modern, I mean modern in philosophical terms, where positivism is, I mean, a philosophical system recognizing only that which can be scientifically verified or which is capable of logical or mathematical proof, therefore questioning metaphysics and faith. In the view of Auguste Comte, the founder of modernist philosophy, explained in his work, The Course in Positive Philosophy, the human culture actually, according to him, develops in three stages. The first stage is a theological stage, where there is no rhyme, no reason for what the gods did, for just they rule over certain things. You don't question, you don't ask any reason here. So gods, they can do whatever they want. So gods and spirits are powerful, be it in Greek religion, the ancient Roman religion, both monotheism or polytheism. So people explain all natural events as the work of supernatural powers. The second stage is metaphysical. I would say the abstract theory with no basis in reality, where people think an abstract power that guides events in the world according to certain fixed principles. Scientific and religious views coexist to make sense of the world. So people like Plato, Aristotle, Newton, they are scientific, but they believe that there is some sort of system behind everything that makes sense. There are universal laws based on these abstract principles. People have rights, but these rights are God-given. Religion is also based on principles and gives us the structure rather than ancient religions. And the third stage is positive. In this stage, looking at things exclusively on scientific method. The only valid knowledge is knowledge gained through the scientific method, through experimentation and observation. Pure scientific and totally independent of religious metaphysics, which means challenging religion. Positive philosophy that does not rely on any kind of religion and metaphysics. So this is what I mean by positivism. The another rationale for religion is as stipulated by Locke, right, in his writings, Letters Concerning Toleration. He wrote in the aftermath of the European Wars on Religion, formulated classic reasoning for religious tolerance. So he puts forward three arguments why toleration is important. First, earthly judges, the state in particular, and human beings generally cannot dependably evaluate the truth, claims of competing religious standpoints. So this is the first argumentation. The second one, even if they could, enforcing a single true religion would not have the desired effect, because belief cannot be compelled by violence. And the third argumentation is, coercing religious uniformity would lead to more social disorder than allowing diversity. So here are the arguments of famous philosophers why toleration is important. Apparently, this it wasn't an easy journey for the world society to get to this level. And many countries take toleration for granted. Even in Azerbaijan, we should not take toleration for granted. This is one of the Azerbaijan's assets and one of Azerbaijan's values. How did it happen? As a distinguished speaker in our panel mentioned, I don't know if we have found the true answer to this. What was the past that we are sure that definitely led to what we have today? Of course, we mentioned about the fact that we are placed between the civilizations and we are placed on the road, on the Silk Road route. The historical source of multiculturalism and interreligious tolerance in Azerbaijan is with the geographic location of the country. It is located on the way of the ancient Silk Road, which allowed a lot of merchants or travelers to leave their footprint of their ethnocultural and religious background in Azerbaijan. And our country was exposed to many religions and cultural backgrounds, which established cultural and religious awareness of the inhabitants in these territories. Perhaps in a way, to some extent, it's similar to the impact of modern global capitalism, if you like. The mercantilist ability of Azerbaijani tradesmen also tells us about the ability to have a respect for diversity in an attempt to seek the ways of coexistence. It's worth mentioning again that the constitution and the legislation of Azerbaijan does not absolutely discriminate against the ethnocultural, racial, or religious background of the applicant. I can give you one example. For example, unlike many countries, the immigration and citizenship policy does not favor at all Azerbaijanis against any other people coming from different backgrounds. So, Azerbaijanis living in Georgia, when they apply for bureaucracy here, they face exactly the same problems any other person from different background would face. So our domestic law does not have a favorable policy to ethnic Azerbaijanis who would like to settle here or to have citizenship. Azerbaijan is regarded as a heaven for many, and the idea is promoted by our colleagues here, by the organizers of this conference. It could be given certain credence if we all agree that even the understanding of heaven isn't the same in all religions. So heavens are also interpreted differently. So when you say it's heaven for all religions, we all are encouraged to have our own personal opinion. Despite the technical difficulties, by the way, I heard Christina Sanchez arguing about religion being personal and private. And interestingly, the top-down power structure in Azerbaijan is politically motivated to encourage a bottom-up structure. In other words, people are encouraged in this country to interpret their holy books as they see fit. Without, of course, to the extent it is not influenced, affected by foreign influence or impact. The concern is about preventing the external influence on and promotion of religious radicalism, as we know. The role of media, of course, it's important. On the one hand, media is industry. It wants to earn profit, make money by selling their sensational news and other products. Sensational news are selling more than non-sensational ones. But on the other hand, ethics and responsibility should be mentioned here and needs to be considered. Well, having a code of ethics is a positive sign of responsibility by the journalists. So let's hope it works in practice. We pride ourselves that toleration is established in Azerbaijan, which is not a very common experience in the entire world, and it's true. But I was just sharing with my colleagues in the coffee break. There is a slow, and I wonder if there's slow and nascent tendency to select the worst instances, examples of European countries and compare our experience with their instances. So I also wonder whether continuously comparing our experience with the worst examples is helpful for us. Because one way or another, it might instill into our subconscious that we are in the best situation when it comes to interreligious toleration worldwide. So we may start thinking that, okay, we can relax and there is no need to go an extra mile. So we should work harder to develop the interreligious toleration we already have in our country, as well as other universal values and principles of human rights. So we cannot go backwards. We are the country where we pride ourselves that we gave we were way ahead of many countries from the Western world to grant women a right of vote. So we should be attentive not to provoke and to carefully prevent any possible risks that we might that they might be against our values, the Azerbaijan values. So I think I'll stop here and thank you for your attention.